Hello everyone and welcome back to Let's Play System Shock 2. Last time we left off, we had arrived in Engineering B. We are looking for Cargo Bay 2, where we can find the code to Fluidics Control. So let's pick it up there. There's a second brawn boost implant in there. This one's fully charged, so I might as well swap it out. Ah yes, cutscene.
Do you not trust the feelings of the flesh? Our biology yearns to join with yours.
We welcome you to our mass.
But you puzzle us. Why do you serve our mother?
How can you choose cold metal for the splendor of flesh? But you fear us.
We hear your thoughts, and they rage for your brothers you believe dead.
But they are not.
They sing in our symphony of life. We offer another chance to join us. If you choose to lie down with the machine,
we will rend you apart
and put you separate from the joy of the mass.
Ha! I knew it! I did pull up Google, and I did hear Stephen Russell speaking as one of the three voices of the many. He's using his Garrett voice in some places. I think his normal voice sounds like Garrett. He also, just in case you're wondering, does the voice of Xerxes and of William Bedford Diego. Anyway, let's get back to work. I saw one evaluation of playing System Shock 2 on Impossible Difficulty that said, rather than a sci-fi horror RPG shooter, Shock 2 on Impossible is a wrench simulator, which gives you the joy of hitting many different things with a wrench. There's a lot of truth to that. Anyway, an audio log, Siddons, June 2nd, 2114. Regarding lame old me.
They aren't making this easy for us, are they? I miss you. I know it's stupid, but I do. I think I'll wallow in self-pity for an hour or so and then write you again. Figures, I have to travel 67 trillion miles to meet a man. Once you're transferred to the Von Braun, everything will be better. I'll be better. I promise. Great. Someone's coming. Counting the seconds.
I hear a protocol droid. There it was. Alright. Simple enough, let's search the crates. There's another one.
That's the triathlon way. Oh, very good, sir. I'm sure this is just what you were looking for.
Come on.
This place.
There we go. Anyway, we got our three packs of cigarettes, four bottles of liquor, a game cartridge, version 1 repairing software, and a game cartridge Overworld Zero, which is a new one. Let's see what that looks like. Entering Overworld Zero. 10 out of 10 HP, level 1, no GP, no XP, no potions. I just killed a slime. Got 2 XP. Killed a bat, got 2 XP. Killed a goblin, 3 XP. I don't have 15 GP. Anyway, it's a little RPG. That's pretty cool. Game over. A bat has killed you. Killed by a bat. 44 turns, level 1, 2 GP, 11 XP. And it restarts.
All right.
No!
Bird, kill me!
All right. Tag another hybrid. Let's unload his shotgun. And let's head through here. Get under that camera. Deal with it. Alright. Command control, cargo bay 1A and 1B. Cargo bay 2A and 2B. Well, cargo bay 2 is where our code's supposed to be.
Access needed.
But we need to find a key card to get in there. Alright, let's try command control. That corpse has nothing. Alright. Looks like we got a crowded room here. Come on!
You.
All right, we got him. The idea was to blow those so I wouldn't get radiated again. Still think it's a pretty solid plan. If I can just do that without getting shot. Be in business. Much junk.
We
that one'll disappear before I can even think about accomplishing anything with it, so let's just head back through the bulkhead for now. We'll drop all our junk back at the main elevator.
Your death card,
quiet!
had a med hypo. That's at least kinda useful. Alright. Let's drop all our junk here. Alright. And now we'll keep going. All right. Once more unto the breach, as they say.
Is there silence?
The discord. May I help you up?
Insufficient. Success. As I thought, the hybrid I was after is vanished. Need to get up there and wrench that monkey. Hybrid. All right. Inside this crate, we find 6 anti-personnel bullets and 6 rifled slugs. I haven't seen anti-personnel bullets yet. While nearly useless against armored targets, the Might Anti-Personnel round is devastatingly effective against flesh and blood. Nanites inside the head of the clip autonomically sense when the round has entered an organic target. First, the head of the bullet fragments into several dozen pieces. Immediately, they seek the highest local temperature and, using microscopic pockets of gas, propel themselves towards the warmth and presumably the vital organs. Also, never actually looked at my light combat armors or my hazard suits. Total failure on my part. The Dartek Class 1 armor requires a strength of 2 in order to equip. The armor is a complex mesh of Kevlar and substrate steel mesh that provides lightweight, marginally effective firepower stoppage. The armor is not only designed to resist penetration, but also to disperse the kinetic energy of the impact throughout its frame. Dartek is the arm of Triops' military branch that generally supplies the poorer belligerents, such as terrorists and local militias. While it's better than nothing, more than one wearer has met an unpleasant end while wearing the Dartek Class 1. Let's look at the hazard suit. The Trioptimum zero-phase hazard armor uses a combination of triple-layer rubberized mesh, reflective shielding, and low-intensity force field path warps in order to protect its wearer from not only vacuum, but other environmental hazards such as radiation and chemical spills. Competitors such as the Hazus Shield Group and Wykodyne have claimed that keeping force field generators so close to the skin for long periods of time can be carcinogenic, but most wearers are more concerned about short-term hazards and prefer the added protection. That item has not yet been researched, of course. All right. Oh yeah, let's search the turret husk. Nothing. Nothing over here, but a couple of explosive barrels. Over here, we have a recharging station. Glorious. Three crates out here. 2 bottles of liquor. two packs of cigarettes and another bottle of liquor, two packs of cigarettes and an audio log, Suarez, July 11th, 2114. Regarding hang tight.
Stay where you are, Beck, I mean it. This isn't something you can fight. This isn't something you can run from. If you love me, you won't come looking for me. Just hang tight. I won't let you down.
Alright, let's check the multiple levels of this now. Starting here, we find a disposable maintenance tool. Then up on the top level, we find pack of cigarettes, bottle of liquor, two bags of chips, five nanites, two bottles of very strong vodka, and a bottle of juice, five nanites, three packs of cigarettes, and another liquor bottle. In here, 10 nanites and two liquor bottles. And for me, it's time to go drop junk again. Time once more to cross through the forest of respawns.
Alright, open.
Come here, son. Where are you going?
I'm...
Five nanites.
Silence the Discord.
It's a good thing he was a pipe hybrid, not a shotgun. Anyway. Let's just head right back to the main elevators for now. Oh, I can't pick up any of his stuff. Unfortunately. Let's leave all the stuff here. Onward. And back again. Let's head back up here. Pick up what we left behind, which is one bottle of liquor and two more bottles of liquor. All right, let's go check out these grav shafts leading up to shuttle control. Command control.
Not me. No way. They're not gonna get me. They're not gonna change me. Rachel? Kids? I'm sorry.
Too slow. Pipe hybrid has nothing. There's the shotgun guy.
You have left us.
6 anti-personnel shotgun shells plus the usual broken shotgun. There's a camera over here. Let's go destroy it. Here's the resurrection station for Engineering B. Alright, doesn't appear to be anything up here. Here are the other two upgrade stations. Stat, I have 13 modules, not quite enough to raise agility. And can't raise research either. So, let's search around here instead. Here's an audio log. Diego, July 11th, 2114. Regarding resist the call.
My duty is to the UNN and to this ship. But can I resist the call of the many? My father's weakness brought Shodan into existence. My weakness has invited these things aboard the Von Braun. Can I undo the wrong I have done?
Let's search the corpses. We find 5 nanites. And 5 nanites. Systems monitoring unit. Alright. That's it for now. This is not where the key card is, so it must be in Cargo Bay 1. So let's head there now. Down he goes. Let's head into Cargo Bay 1. On the corpse, we find nothing. The card reader is busted, and we can get into the cargo bay. Protocol droids. Of course, it's a shotgun hybrid. Got a maintenance bot to deal with, too. Damn it. Hoping the hybrid will leave eventually. That's probably hoping too much.
You have left us. You have left us.
If I could just get back to the wall fast enough, we'd be good.
Left us.
Damn, so close.
You have won.
There we go. Perfect execution. Good. Let's take his shotgun and unload it, like usual. Nothing on the droid remains either. Now let's finish busting up this crate. Protocol droid shipping crate.
This is Xerxes. Can you not feel the glory of the flesh? Do you not? This is Xerxes. Can you not feel the glory of the flesh? This is Xerxes. Can you not feel the glory of the flesh? Do you not yearn to be free of the tyranny of the individual?
Yes.
Oh, perfect. Perfect. All right. I like to destroy all of these. Burnout, too much. Again? Come on. Good. If you don't destroy these things as you run into them, they definitely do start spitting droids at you, which can be rather inconvenient. That was awesome. Alright, let's search the crates first. Nothing. Here's our first auto-diagnostic medical kit. Let's query it. The self-diagnostic medical kit is able to stop bleeding, rebuild damaged tissue, and even make rudimentary organ repair. A staple of emergency medical technicians, battlefield medics, and policemen everywhere, the medical kit will restore all lost hit points. Is he shotgun? No, he's pipe. Good. And he's got a can of soda. Perfect. Alright, let's check out the replicator.
Hi there. Please make your selection.
Can't hack it, but we've got a soda can for 6, a disposable maintenance tool for 120, rifled slugs for 160, and a strength booster for 100. 1A is protocol droid storage. Should I go left? left or right first? Let me peek at my map. Okay, 1B is... Well, that one's... That one is shotgun, so... I should go left first. 1B is through there, so... That's what I like to see. I forgot that was already finished. This is gonna work on either of them. Not in one shot. Oh. Oh, good. I do like to see that. Alright, let's work on destroying this one. I think one more wrench hit will kill me.
Pipe. Your flesh will welcome us.
He's not carrying anything. That's fine.
Your flesh will welcome.
And there's another shotgun guy. Good gravy. Just slow the respawn down a little bit. It's insane. Alright, we got a whole bay of crates here. I knew I was gonna run into trouble there. Come on. I'm having a lot of trouble with this.
Right away, sir.
There we go. So much quick loading. These are the wages of impossible difficulty, I am afraid. I hear another hybrid. Did Just had to be a shotgun hybrid, didn't it? Alright. Let's go do two things.
Not part we fall.
Oh, come on! This is out of hand.
Another. We do not part!
Are you of a...
Alright, we need to do two things. I need to hit the charging station in here to keep my brawn boost going. Shouldn't be too tough. And it's already time to offload junk. Come on.
Is there another week?
I mean, it's one thing not to let me clear a level, but this pace is ridiculous. I'm getting mad. I forgot it was so bad, or...
Is there a thing?
Actually, I think the last time I played on Impossible, I cheated. I used a mod to get rid of respawn, which made the game much more bearable. Because this is just nuts. I mean, they are everywhere. It's like, I can't even lower their numbers. I have to fight five going every direction, every time. Well, I'd rather the protocol droid than the hybrid.
That's the triathlon way. Oh, very good, sir. Right away.
That was tough. Almost didn't pull it off. Anyway, offload more junk. We will hold on to the medical kit. That's worth having. Another dead hybrid, and now we're back. All right, let's search this corpse. Five nanites, and there's an access card to get to cargo bay 2A and 2B. But I think we should search the rest of 1A and 1B. Don't you? Come on, suicide.
Right away, sir.
Dang it. Alright, that was better. Damn it.
Hurry! This area is clear, so let's go up to level 2.
Marvelous choice, if I do say so myself.
Right. Turnaround I wanted to. Alright. That's handled. We've got box of 6 standard bullets. 10 nanites up here. Got another hybrid on the ground level, but thankfully we're away from there for now. Let's call this lift up here.
Your flesh betrays you.
Let's head up to level 3. We'll let him hunt around down there. That's fine. Oh shit. Turret.
Song is not ours.
Hey, we got 3 cyber modules up here. That's enough to raise my agility. Which is awesome. I vote we do it. What? It would have had to just spawn him on the elevator. That's insane.
You need help finding something. Wait, come back.
Dang it. I was trying to convince the droid to blow the turret for me. Or at least to help me, but I don't think that's gonna happen.
I am at your...
Damn it. I knew that was gonna kill me.
Come.
Oh, if I had just moved a little bit sooner.
Marvelous choice. I do say so myself. Right away, sir.
Come on.
Right away, sir. Right away, sir. Right away, sir. I beg your pardon. Right away, sir.
Damn it.
Right away, sir. Right away, sir. Marvelous choice. I do say so myself.
Damn it.
Right away, sir.
Perfect. And now I should be able to get the turret. Now we've got another droid. Let's detonate it. Alright. Destroyed turret, there's nothing. Let's keep looking around up here. One. Come on. Need a psi hypo. Let's destroy these others. There seem to be two in a sort of stack. So we'll blow one and then we'll blow the other. Come on. Alright. Now we can really poke around over here. We got three cyber modules. There's a security crate that I can't hack, of course. And we're ready to head back down to the ground level. Thank you. let's go upgrade my agility right quick.
Your song
is not out.
It's going to make everything easier if I can move faster. Okay, agility goes to 3. Already, I move noticeably faster, which is good. Now, what do I want to upgrade next? My next psionics upgrade costs 53. My next stat upgrade will cost 26. Research to 1 only costs 17, so that's what I'll do next. Research to 1. It'll happen when I hit 17 modules. Ooh. The other half of 1A is still protocol droid storage, unfortunately. Let's see what we can find in here. Between us and an attractive looking stash of nanites. My move didn't work that time. I'm having some trouble with it here. Come on. There we go. Another one.
That's the triathlon way.
Two more. One more.
Sir, where are you?
Come on, dude. Too slow.
Oh, very close.
So close. There we go. Got him. All right. Behind all of those, we find... Oh. 5 nanites and 6 armor-piercing bullets. All right, let's check out the second level. Corpse up here with 6 anti-personnel shotgun shells and 5 nanites. Is that it? Is there anything else? Looks like no. Let's head up to level 3. Lights are brighter up here. On top of any of the boxes. The body has 15 nanites and a bag of chips. That really appears to be it, so let's head over into 1B. I hear a monkey. It is. I hear at least 2 more. Could be more than that. This is data wheel storage. They must all be on higher levels. Well, there's a security crate back here. I can't hack it, of course. I also find a box of 6 standard bullets. It's handy, I suppose. Oh, there's one. I don't know if he jumped down or if he just spawned, but... Come on. There we go. There's one. Dang it. One more. Also sounds like it's above me. Over here we have 6 standard bullets. Alright, let's head up to level 3. Killed that one. This body has nothing. This body has 2 cyber modules and 10 nanites. That's a good find. That appears to be it for here. I'm gonna take a quick run to command control to keep my implant juiced. Then we'll come back and finish up Cargo Bay 1B. Of course. Got the shotgun guy. Pipe guy has 5 nanites. And we're juiced. Let's get right back in there. Hey, nanites. 5 nanites. Yahoo. Okay. Here's a security station. Inside the desk, we have 5 nanites and an audio log. Malone, July 6th, 2114. Regarding further experiments.
Taking precautions, I proceeded with further experiments. Since we've reached Tau Ceti, creatures have gotten smarter and somehow gained limited psi abilities. I probed another subject with a beta 5 cycle and sensed many things, but mostly an incredible empathy. The chimps have become acutely aware of their own history, of the vivisections and experiments that have been performed on them while on board the Von Braun. They have anger, and they are ready to express it. Clearly, they are both a fascinating scientific resource and an incredible security risk. My recommendation? Either freeze them in cryo storage for the remainder of the mission, or liquidate them immediately. Who knows what other abilities they'll acquire.
Okay. Over here we find a body, a psi hypo, and a swift boost implant, which raises my agility. It's probably handier than the brawn boost. So let's swap it out. An unresearched object! Oh yes. I should query the Swift Boost implant. The Swift Boost trademark implant boosts agility by 1, burning up 1% of its charge, and... Come on. Let's try that again. Burning up 1% of its charge every 10 seconds, while the Run Fast trademark implant focuses on implant concentrates on stimulating the leg muscles, the Swift Boost trademark implant speeds up reaction times for the entire body. This implant is popular among gymnasts and other athletes, but hasn't caught on fully with the military yet. And here's an audio log, Malone, July 13th, 2114, regarding psionic chimps.
A laboratory worker from MedSci called me down to the vivisection room yesterday. He felt the lab chimps were exhibiting uncommon intelligence. I sat with one for 4 hours and tried to probe it with the psi-amp on a beta 4 cycle. It failed to respond. I, of course, assumed it was because it was incapable of reacting to the sophisticated beta 4 cycle. But then, I realized it was blocking the probe intentionally. As soon as I raised the psi-amp to attack it, the creature lashed out with its arms and projected a cryokinetic field towards me, paralyzing my arm. I immediately side-dampened the monkey, and then stunned it with an electric prod.
Interesting. Anyway, this, of course, is just... All it's good to say is this item is not yet researched. That's all it ever says. Until we research. Alright, let's check out the rest of this ground level. I see something up here. A suit of light combat armor. Over here, 5 nanites. And I'm not far away from having to go make another junk drop off. Which is really too bad. Alright. Let's head up to level 2. There's something up here. I can hear it walking around. Come on, let's try again. It's just hard to see. And I really don't want to get tagged. Come on. Whoa, come on, come on. Bagged him. See, alright, time to make my junk run, but because there's at minimum a pistol in here I've gotta pick up. There's nothing on that corpse. Well, there was actually a box of ammo and some nanites, I should say. I've got everything off of that corpse. Loving the swift boost, coupled with my native agility increase. This is loads of fun. I was about to say, dealing with the droids should be a lot easier now. Hey, that hybrid had a med hypo. What do you know? Back, 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 all the way back. Come on. I know it's really, really tedious picking everything up and shuttling it over to the elevators. The good news is things will really speed up once we finally get the recycler. As we can just carry it with us and recycle things into nanites as we find them. For now, it is unfortunately necessary to keep doing this. Hold on to our unresearched objects. And we'll run back to the cargo bays.
Silence. Silence
the Discord.
He's got nothing. Got nothing. Might as well juice up. It's because I love my speed and I don't want to lose it. This is FTL sequencer storage. Whatever that means. Anyway. We'll get that pistol from here. Unload it. And head up to level 3. Up here we find a shotgun. Poor condition, no ammo, a corpse with 6 rifled slugs, and 2 cyber modules. My total's up to 6. Alright, I think that's it. So let's cross over to Cargo Bay 2 now. Get shot, of course.
We hurry.
Damn.
We blaze.
Got him. Pipe hybrid's got nothing. Shotgun hybrid has a shotgun. I guess that should come as no surprise. What? That soon?
You have
left us.
Did you see that? There he was. I saw him spawn in. I don't even have the decency to wait until I'm out of an area. Alright, here's Cargo Bay 2. We'll go left first. Before we do anything else, let's check out this replicator. It's broken. Can't repair it. Requires a repair skill of 3. Over here? Well, apart from the turret, we have hygienic storage. Boy, that extra agility really shines now. Turret's got nothing. Body has version 1 hacking software, 8 nanites, and an audio log. Bronson, July 6th, 2114. Regarding hacking turrets.
Well, we can't get the malfunctioning turrets offline, and now Xerxes isn't even talking to us. Pollard thought of a workaround. By running bypass into central control, we can hack into the turrets locally and take control of them. However, that means walking right up to the little sons of bitches and hoping they don't go off. One thing is sure, I'm going to figure out what the hell happened here.
Corpse has 6 rifled slugs on it. A There's another shotgun there, and it's time for another junk deposit already. That body has nothing. Anyway. Another hybrid out there already. We can take his bottle of liquor at least. I had had about enough.
Hot hours.
That didn't work.
The sound is not up.
And back. We got to witness the spawn again. These guys should definitely be easier with the extra agility.
This is just what you were looking for.
This is killing me. There we go. Juice again, since we're right here. Might as well. Alright, come on. Into Cargo Bay 2. Hang a left. Okay. What we need to do is check out level 2. This lift has been taken offline for repairs. Alright, guess we will take this one then. I hear something above me. Let's not do that. Instead, let's just jump over there, which we can do with our agility.
We are.
Is he here, or is he on level 3? Box of 6 standard bullets. There's another set of nanites. Probably have to get those with Psypole, which is fine. Now let's head up to level 3.
You do not hide.
He had a shotgun. No problem. Up here, we've got 2 cyber modules and a bag of chips. And a security crate, which I, of course, cannot hack. Now, we can't step on the broken lift, or it will fall and we will die. But if we lean forward, we can trigger the lift falling. Then we can head back down and pick the nanites up off the ground. Nice and easy. Alright. Let's head this way now. That was hygienic storage. This is medical supply storage.
Who joins us here?
Hybrid's got nothing. This corpse has a med hypo and a surgical unit activation key, which I'll definitely hold on to. Nothing else on this level, so let's head to level 2.
Run.
That hybrid we're hearing must be on level 3. Here we've got a box of 6 standard bullets. And that appears to be it. Alright. Bagged him. Let's take his 5 nanites and his shotgun. Run. 5 nanites here. And that appears to be all. So I guess now we'll head over into 2B. Pipe hybrid, shotgun hybrid, and it's time for a junk drop-off. No surprise there. Med hypo and 5 nanites. Awesome. Stuff. Yes, indeed. Surgical unit activation key is worth carrying. got nothing. Let's juice up since we're over here. Stay nice and fast. Keep my implants powered. And we'll head back over to 2B.
Your flesh will welcome us.
Well, that sucked. All right. Got one. Check out level 1. Turret. Naturally. Anything else over here? No. Alright, let's deal with the turret. Shotgun. And now let's check out level 2. This lift is malfunctioning. Maintenance will arrive shortly. Please wait. Head up to level 3. Nothing. Security crate. On this corpse, we've got 6 standard bullets and a pistol, which we'll unload. Alright, let's head down to ground level and deal with that robot. Wrenchy, wrenchy, wrenchy. My wrench is my friend. I got 2 robots. Wonderful.
All means of service for the vulnerable will be suspended.
Don't spawn in guys
this
behind
is
me. I can't deal with it right now.
This is Xerxes. Due to measures beyond our control, all meal service aboard the Von Braun will be suspended. Nutritious snacks are available at most replicators. This is Xerxes. Due to measures beyond our control, all meal service...
They are shooting me through the boxes.
This
That's
is
good,
Xerxes.
You know?
Due to measures beyond our control, all meal service aboard the Von Braun will be suspended. Nutritious snacks are available at most replicators. This is Xerxes. Due to measures beyond our control, all meal service aboard the Von Braun.
Come on.
This is Xerxes. Due to measures beyond our control, all meal service. This is Xerxes. Due to measures beyond our control, all meal service aboard the Von Braun will be suspended. Nutritious snacks are available at most replicators.
Well, we got
this
one of them.
This is Xerxes. Due to measures beyond our control, all meal service aboard the Von Braun will be suspended. Nutritious snacks are available at most replicators.
There's another fucking shotgun hybrid. This is ridiculous. Damn it. There, I thought I was doing awesome. Come on.
Let me tell you that, sir.
I don't know why I kept playing. I had already taken a hit. Damn it. This is killing me. Five whacks, then I need to shoot him and cry. Four. Three. Two. One. Zero. And now, cryo. Alright. Nothing on that one. Looks like the first one has disappeared. Thanks to the insane hybrid respawn rate, it's already time for another junk drop-off. Too annoyed to even kill those things just yet. Hey, All right. On and on it goes. Alright, well, we've got at least one protocol droid and two hybrids after us.
Run.
That's a pipe hybrid. Got him, no trouble. There's a shotgun hybrid who has inexplicably taken some damage. It's good, it should make him easier to deal with. My preferred method of the bum rush. There's protocol droid. I'm content to just leave it where it is. Medical supply storage. Oh my god, just a pipe. Finally. And he drops a can of soda. Anyway, what we just cleared was nutritional matter storage. Let's check this middle zone out. Just a mug and a desk. With cigarettes, 5 nanites, and an audio log. Diego, July 11th, 2114. Regarding, is it so bad?
In some ways, the many is not unlike the UNN. There's a joy in working towards a collective goal, and being able to put aside the things that draw us apart and make us separate. Why do we fear the loss of our individuality so much? Man can dream, but the many can accomplish.
Now that I know that's Stephen Russell, he really sounds like Garrett. Anyway, here's another audio log. Here at Freshwater Storage. It's Delacroix, July 5th, 2114. Regarding, be brave.
Constance, I fear now for my life. I think this has gone beyond any imaginings of Diego and Korenchkin. I do not believe they are in control at all. We must discover what it was they found down on the surface of Tau 75 and why they guard the secret so jealously. I think this is more important than my life, or your life, or the life of this ship. Be brave, and be careful.
Alright. There's a busted lift. We got a corpse here. He's got 6 anti-personnel shotgun shells on him. I can see that lift is busted, so I won't bother. Let's just take this one up to level 2. I hear a robot. This corpse, we've got 6 anti-personnel bullets and 2 cyber modules. She's got a pistol in terrible condition lying next to her. Let's head up to level 3 now. There's a French Epstein device and an audio log. I feel compelled to solve the robot problem first. my gosh. He can shoot through crates, so I have to use the pillar. Too slow. Crud. I can keep up this two whacks at a time thing. That was awesome, too. Alright, four whacks, and then cryo die. Only one more. He is dealt with. Over here, we find a corpse with 10 nanites. 20 nanites on the robot's corpse. I remember that lift is busted. This body has a jammed laser pistol, which I will want to come back for, unfortunately. Here is an audio log. Sanger, July 10th, 2114. Regarding locked in.
Malone's dead. I was just talking to him and this cyborg came up behind him and... Okay, Connie, get a grip. Get a grip. I've recoded the door lock and engineering control to 15061. I think I'll be safe in here. Yeah, I'll be safe in here.
Alright, so now we finally have the code. 15061. Yeah, I mean, I don't want to have to come all the way back here to pick up the laser pistol, but it's kind of how these things go. You just do what you gotta do.
Something
out of place.
Are are you at?
You're so...
Fuck you!
I'm sure this is just
pipe hybrids got nothing. Blew the protocol droid, no problem. Oh. I guess that's how the hybrid got hurt that one time. Guess we'd better go right around this thing. Damn it. No spawn that time. Interesting. Back to the main elevator. There's always something in this tunnel.
I'm finding something. Right away, sir.
Big pile of stuff. We haven't seen it yet. I have no use for it, but let's query the Fritz Epstein device. The perfect birthday gift for the techie with less than ideal technical skills, the Fritz Epstein device is a portable, nanite-driven, self-contained analysis and modification tool. Simply place your weapon in the device and let the Fritz Epstein's expert systems do the work necessary in the weapon's modifications. One use only. So, in case you hadn't figured it out, it's a free weapon mod. Without having to use the skill. Alright. Let's go snag our laser pistol.
Rebirth in a hurry!
Then we will be done with the friggin' cargo maze.
Your flash.
Med hypo. That's good news. Protocol droid, all.
Your flash will welcome us.
You said.
Oh, come on. His animation cut short. Med hypo. Alright. Really quickly, back to the top of 2B. I can almost guarantee there will be something here. Sounds like a protocol droid. Let's leave it where it is. We'll cruise back up to the top. Pick up that damn laser pistol and be done with it. I need to juice my implants on my way out. Well, my implant.
Marvelous choice, if I do say so myself. Right away, sir.
Oh, very good, sir.
Later, bro. Come on! How come the first shot is not staggering him? That time the second one didn't either. Irrelevant. Let's unload his shotgun. Let's power up my implant. and let's get out of here. Droids. Other fucking droids.
I'm sure this is just what we're on the way. Oh, very good away, sir. Right away, sir. I'm sure this is just what you were looking for.
Insufficient.
That's the trick.
There we go. Back toward the engine core. All right. Let's take the grav shaft up to engineering control, which we now have the code for. 15061. Box of 6 anti-personnel bullets. And there's an audio log in here. Delacroix, July 5th, 2114, regarding Fluidics backdoor.
Somebody's been tampering with the Xerxes unit. In the interest of keeping secrets from the powers that be, I've installed a backdoor to the Fluidics control computer. To activate it, install hardware override 45MDEX in the system's monitoring unit in command control. You can find 45MDEX in auxiliary storage 5 in the coolant tubes. Key code 34760.
Well, I'm sure we'll have to do that.
Xerxes is one step ahead of us. He's performed an override on the Fluidics control computer and blocked us out. But keep an eye open. You might be able to find some workaround.
Indeed we have. That email was Polito, July 12th, 2114, regarding Fluidics override. So we need to head back to the coolant tubes, believe it or not. Happily kill him and take his stuff. Since we're here, and since we're full anyway, perform a junk drop-off. Now we gotta head to auxiliary storage 5. Can of soda and 5 nanites. That we haven't seen before. It's a grub. Alright, let's put on the hazard suit. Run through here.
Radiation hazard.
Put our combat armor back on. Auxiliary storage 5 is right in here. What's the code again? Oh, and I haven't been checking my notes either. Yeah, the code for engineering control is 15061. Find a way to override the Fluidics computer. New goals are get unit 45MDEX from auxiliary storage 5, code 34760. Install 45MDEX in command control. Use Fluidics computer in engineering control to purge the tubes. Purge radiation from coolant tubes to reopen engine core. Reset main power at the engine core to restart elevators. So, 34760 gets us in here. What do we find? Well, it's the chemical storeroom, for one, and it's full of parts. I'm gonna leave the chemicals where they are, because I might actually need those.
Well done. I'm uploading some more modules.
I got 10 modules for picking up Unit 45 MDEX. Let's pick up the others. Leave the chemicals where they are. And here's a log. Chemical manifest. Excuse me. Chemical manifest engineering. Laboratory stockroom, inventory, engineering, stockroom 192. Antimony 2, barium 2, californium 2, cesium 1, iridium 2, osmium 1, technetium 1, tellurium 1, vanadium 2, yttrium 2. This inventory list is required by UNN safety code number 134882 to be kept on hand in all areas of hazardous chemical storage. Storage is defined by UNN safety code number 195331 to consist of all areas in which hazardous chemicals, see safety code number 093355, are stored in quantities greater than 50 grams per 10 square feet for durations of greater than 24 hours. Pretty straightforward. That should change our notes, I think. Yes, we got Unit 45 MDEX. So, let's head back through the tubes. Our rockin' awesome agility means we can get through without any radiation damage as long as we have the hazard suit on. Like so.
Radiation hazard.
Keep my light combat armor on otherwise. Yeah, I think I want to go this way. Guy nearby. We can ignore him. Another junk drop off. This time we'll drop this can of soda and every circuit board that isn't 45 MDEX. There's 45 MDEX. So we'll drop the other circuit boards here. Now we gotta head all the way back to command control. So, let's do it. Pipe hybrid. Down he goes. Bonus side note. The 10 modules boosted my total to 20, which is sufficient.
Good. Run!
For an upgrade I want. All of that happens in command control anyway, so let's just get there. Oh, son of a bitch.
The harmony is
disturbed.
Where are you going?
We burn
new flesh. Speak of the many.
Fine, he can go wherever he wants to go. He wants to take off down there. I feel no need to mess with him. Let's juice up and then let's head upstairs. First things first, let's upgrade my research to level 1. Alright, taking it to level 2 only takes 8 modules, so I believe that's what I'll do next. Because I want to take research to at least 4. Yep, research 2 is next. But in the meantime, let's see what I can do with research 1. This is what we got from a hybrid. This is a pulpy, kidney-shaped organ that controls most of a hybrid's vital functions. Chemicals needed to research, none. It's perfect. He'll just go ahead and wait for it. You'll see why.
Research complete.
Research complete. Click the reports button to see the results. Summary. You've learned how to best target the hybrid for maximal damage. All damage you deal to hybrids will be increased by 25%. So we can move this over to the junk pile now. There we go. A hybrid organ. Analysis. DNA structure indicates that this organism is a hybrid of a human host and a parasitic organism. Although the parasite, resembling a yard-long worm, has deteriorated to a stage beyond useful analysis, the effects of the process are evident. Severe deterioration of higher-level mental processes is caused by tumorous growths along the spinal column and brainstem. The non-human tissues seem to be formed of a composite of small worm-like creatures that have adapted into the host body and taken over a majority of motor control and decision-making functions. There also appears to be direct stimulation of the autonomic nervous and glandular systems. Hence, the organism produces exceptional amounts of both adrenaline and endorphins, making it remarkably strong and aggressive. What remains cannot really be called human at all. The damage done to the host by the process is irrevocable, and the organism now functions with no sense of morality or hesitation. Recommendation: the organism is vulnerable to the same forms of stimuli as a human. However, the changes in its physiology suggest a chemistry more complex than is currently understood. Further analysis of similar organisms might provide more insight in this area. Cool. I have two other unresearched objects. Let's look at this one. This looks much like your brain, except that it's smaller and there are hair-like silvery filaments penetrating it. Chemicals needed to research. Fermium. I'm just gonna let that tick up too. Until it tells me it needs the fermium anyway. Sorry, I know this is taking a while. Plus, I have to admit, I kind of like hanging out up here because once you kill the initial two hybrids and destroy the camera, it's a safe zone. All right. Need fermium. That's fine. Let's see if there's any down here. Nope. What about MedSci? Yes, there's fermium back on MedSci, so we'll need to get some of that. In the meantime, we'll suspend our current research and check out this red thing. This spongy reddish organ oozes a clear liquid through many small pores and sphincters. Chemicals needed to research osmium. Is there osmium on engineering? Yes, there is. Okay. So we'll be able to finish this one. And actually, we can finish the brain, too. We'll just have to take a field trip back up to MedSci. I'll be right back. Hit a dead end on our research. For now, let's install 45MDEX here in the system's monitoring unit.
Well done. I'm uploading some more modules.
Fluidics Control Computer Online, 10 modules received, brings me up to 13. I can take my research skill up to 2 before I leave, which is nice. If we look at the notes, now it's just use the fluidics control computer, purge radiation, reset main power at the core. So let's raise research to 2. I'll be back when I have 14 modules to raise it to 3. Hoping the 25% damage boost would help me kill them faster. I was hoping to one-shot pipe hybrids and maybe two-shot shotgun hybrids. No such luck, I guess. Alright. Fluidics control computer's right here, so might as well hit it.
Engine pods online. You have to head to cell 1 and 2 and reset the pods manually. After that, reinitialize the system from core control. But that system won't come online until you reset both pods. Keep an eye out. They're mobilizing their real forces, and they know exactly where you are.
Alright. So we got 10 more modules, so I can go. I'm gonna run back and upgrade research again to take it to 3. I'm also going to juice my Swift boost while I'm there. Anyway, Polito's email, July 12th, 2114, regarding the engine pods. Now we have to reset the starboard engine nacelle, reset the port engine nacelle, and reset main power at the engine core to restart the elevators. So, let's just do everything we've got to do.
Go!
I barely even noticed he was there.
It is that we do
not welcome you.
Kill me!
This damage bonus isn't doing much. Eat shit, assholes. Alright. Take research to 3 right quick. Twenty-one, 26, and 53, so, yeah. Research to 4 is what I'll do next. Then I'll be done with it. Need to come back when I have 21 modules. Anyway, let's juice my Swift Boost implant. Now let's head back this direction. Oh, come on. I get so sick of these guys. They just keep coming. All right, let's head through here now. All right, well, there he is.
Kill me!
Gladly. I'll take his 5 nanites, too. All right, let's just... Whoa. Keep on going. Right back to here. Do a jump drop off, and we can drop off the hybrid organ too. We keep the benefits from researching it without having to carry it in our inventory, thankfully. All right, let's reactivate research on this red guy. The tubes are clear of radiation now, so we don't even have to worry about it, which is awesome. That dude's still there, no problem. I'm gonna keep ignoring him. Let's run back here and get some osmium. And we'll use it. Apply it to our research. Whoa! There's a back room here with a monkey in it. Monkey's got nothing. The desk has 10 nanites and 6 standard bullets. Anyway, let's wait for the research to conclude on this thing. You'll notice it's moving much faster with Research 3 as opposed to Research 1. Done. Click the reports button to see the results. Annelid healing gland. Summary. This tissue can be used to physically heal damage. Analysis. This gland secretes a prolific mix of hormones and stimulatory enzymes, and a quickly dividing layer of cells spawns off multipurpose circulatory cells. These cells seek out sites of tissue damage and graft themselves into the tissue, taking on the characteristics of the local host tissue in a matter of moments. Recommendation. The shared tissue compatibilities between human and annelid tissue will allow this gland to be used for healing, though not as fully as it would in an annelid host. Once removed from the host's body, it can only be used once. That's fine. Let's rearrange a little bit. So now we've got another source of healing. Any annelid healing glands we find, we will certainly carry with us. Let's head back out of here. Let's reactivate research on the brain. And I'm just gonna shoot up the ladder to deck 2 and grab the fermium we need to finish that research. Since I'm in here anyway, and the tunnels aren't dangerous anymore. Here's where we came into the level. Here's our junk depository. Put a few more standard bullets there. Can't hurt anything. In here, let's find the fermium. Use it and head back down to engineering. I happen to know this room is safe, so let's just wait and see what we can see.
Research complete.
All right. Monkey brain. Summary, you've learned how to best target the monkeys for maximal damage. All damage you deal to monkeys will be increased by 25%. Analysis. The monkey is genetically normal, an African squirrel monkey. However, it appears to have been subject to a large number of chemical and surgical procedures both before and after birth. These procedures have enhanced brain size and connectivity, as well as enhanced the myelination of the central nervous system. The skull of the creature has been surgically removed, presumably both to prevent cranial pressure and to allow quick experimental access. Recommendation. The neural construction of the creature is similar in nature to psionic human neural structure. The monkeys are likely to have psionic capability. They are vulnerable to all attacks which affect standard organic creatures. Sweet. Alright, now, after all that work, we should finally be able to open the door to the engine core. Access granted, radiation contained. Let's head up here. Come on. There you go, Hoss. Main power's still offline. Let's check out this replicator.
Hi there. Please make your selection.
Still can't hack it, but cigarettes, 10 nanites, 6 standard bullets, 120, antitoxin hypo, 70, psi hypo, 150. Nothing. Pipe hybrid has nothing. I think that's gonna take me to the nacelles. Let's go down here first. Security control station. Corpse with 15 nanites. And a laser rapier. Unfortunately, we can't use it in this game, but let's look at it and feel a little nostalgic. A brutally effective melee weapon, the laser rapier requires an agility of 3 and an energy weapon skill of 4 in order to use. far more effective than the prototype model first developed on Citadel Station in 2072, the Mark IV laser rapier is a much more reliable piece of technology. The unit works by projecting a porous field of reflective material in a shaft-shaped region around the base of the rapier. When the material is bent, as when the rapier strikes a target, the intense refracted light inside is released locally, causing intense burns to the target. That's right, just like the one the hacker used on Citadel Station. We're the only one in town who's got 'em. Only 40 nanites. Street vendor selling laser rapier replicas in New Detroit. Interesting. Boy, that, I think, is the other nacelle. That, I think, is the actual core, so let's hit the nacelles first. The bum rush will work. Just have to not get tagged.
Silence.
There we go. Take the fool's shotgun. This body has 8 nanites on it. Here's the port nacelle. It's online. Let's go check out the ground level. I knew that was gonna hurt me. Gotta get down the ladder. Let's check down here first. See nothing. Nothing here either. Let's check inside this neat-looking tunnel. There is nothing. Okay. Well, let's head over to the starboard nacelle now. Do essentially the same thing. We got a protocol droid. Try and bum rush the monkey. Got close, but couldn't quite pull it off. Come here, douche. We can one-shot monkeys. That's good. That pipe hybrid has nothing.
Silence.
Same as that one. Alright. Starboard nacelle. We've got enemies respawning. Par for the course, really. There's a camera up there. We'll have to destroy with cryokinesis. Alright, let's search the ground level. Since we're over here. There is a corpse down here with 2 cybernetic modules on it. Thank you very much. Brings my total to a spectacular, inspiring 3. Let's check inside the... There's a monkey! Which we can one-shot. The research did make a difference there. Here we have an unresearched object, a box of 6 rifled slugs, and a medical kit. Chemicals needed to research, sodium and iridium. Here we've got a shotgun in shoddy condition. Let me see about those chemicals. no sodium here, but there is iridium. Is there sodium on MedSci? No. So I can't research this thing yet. I need to find some sodium first.
I suppose they shall wait for me as they return.
All right. Let's head up here. Idiot. Step off the ladder onto the balcony, please. There you go. There's a protocol droid.
That's the triathlon way.
Awesome.
Right away, sir.
Alright, come on, asshole. Explode.
Oh, very good, sir.
Well, not quite like that. That's more like it. Alright, as we head in here... Starboard nacelle is online. We got another corpse with 10 nanites. And here we have an audio log. Delacroix, July 11th, 2114. Regarding a new friend.
I've been contacted by some kind of artificial intelligence that wants to help me reclaim control of the Von Braun from whomever or whatever is now in charge. I don't know where it came from, but I must confess, I'm happy it is here.
Well, first, it asked for iridium, which I think I do have down here on engineering, so...
Oh, very good, sir.
Sorry.
Protocol droid killed the pipe hybrid for me. Nice. Alright. Let's head up here now. I think this is where we can restore the power. There's a hybrid out there, of course. There's another pile of those worms.
Kill me!
I'll take his shotgun and unload it. Here's a door with a code we do not know. Didn't notice that camera. Almost got into real trouble. I think I can reach that one with the wrench. Oh, I guess not. Alright. I will blow it with cryo then. No problem. Now let's head back into here. Let's avoid those worms. Here we just have some sort of office with a bunch of goodies that I have no room for, so I'll have to come back. What we can go ahead and do is turn on the engine core.
Good work. The engine core is now back online. Now get to the elevator and come see me on deck 4. While you're doing that, I've discovered the presence of some annelid artifacts on board the ship. I think you may be able to use them to your advantage. I've uploaded the information to the ship's weapons upgrade units. They'll be able to convey the information to your cybernetic rig. What are you waiting for? Get to the elevator now.
All right. So that email was Polito, July 12th, 2114, regarding Core Online. We got 10 cyber modules, brings my total to 13, which is not enough for any of the upgrades I want. I'm running to the elevator right now for a junk drop. And I might as well run to Auxiliary Storage 5 and grab the iridium while I'm here.
Power drained.
Oh. I need to juice up my swift boost. I'm not that worried. Where's my iridium? There we go. Let's apply it. And then we'll just hold on to it until we find some sodium, which will let us finish researching it. Need to do a junk drop before I do anything else. Let's go this way. Let's try to avoid him rather than engage him. We're closing in. The elevator's online now. As you can see. Monkey brain is junk now, too. Alright, let's head to the engine core so we can loot that. There, it needs sodium. Not get hit by a grub. That's just embarrassing. Come on. You can do it. There you go. Back to the engine core. We're going to loot that office, and then there's one other place we still haven't been on engineering. Open that again. All right. Now that we're in here, bottle of juice, bottle of liquor, bottle of very strong vodka, mug. Cigarettes, inside the desk, a Psy Hypo and 10 nanites, and an audio log, Sanger, July 4th, 2114, regarding Delacroix.
I don't know where we'd be without Delacroix. This whole ship is falling apart. She's the only one who knows what from what. I saw her arguing with that creep Anatoly Kreskin or whatever his name is, and she was giving it to him but good. That freak job stares her straight in the eye and starts babbling about how she doesn't know the pleasure of the joyful unity or some such. Mamma mia, the clowns are running the circus.
All right. One other thing to do. That's this lift and its counterpart, which we saw earlier. Security crate, which I can't hack, of course. I hear a hybrid. There he is.
A thousand. Ah! Kill me! Ah!
Bagged him. No real trouble. That's the way I like it. Got two corpses here. 12 nanites, two cyber modules. Bring my total to 15. A speed booster and a pistol in poor condition. Unloaded as well. There's a turret right there. What I really like to do is get by it and wrench it. I think I'm still fast enough to do, even without an implant. Shotgun hybrid. That naturally. It had to be shotgun. Couldn't be a pipe.
I'm sorry.
Kill me!
He's dead. I can't take his shotgun, of course. That went right through the turret, somehow. Astounding, really. There we got it. If you're wondering why I kept going forward instead of turning back, it's because the other end of this passage is really just as close to the main elevator as the engine core end is. That's our first cyborg midwife. She's not carrying anything. Good. Expert level takedowns on all comers. Let's search this last corpse. Two more boxes of standard bullets. Now let's ride the lift up. Blow one more droid.
Oh, very good, sir.
Before we leave. Got him. All right. Drop all the junk. Let's get in the elevator. Here's our floor selector. We can head up to MedSci. Awesome. So, Dr. Polito's on deck 4. Error, shaft inaccessible. Okay, what about 3? Hydroponics.
Damn, something's blocking the shaft, and the elevator can't reach deck 4. I'm attempting to determine. I'm detecting massive quantities of some kind of biomaterial that's plugging up the elevator shaft. The environment on this level has been altered to be some kind of breeding chamber for the xenomorphs. It shouldn't prove dangerous unless you plan to stay for more than a few hours. But in order to clear the shaft, you're going to have to remove the biomaterial. I'm accessing the primary data loop. Let's see what we can find out there.
All right. So that email was Polito, July 12th, 2114, regarding blocked shaft. So, clear the biomaterial from the elevator shaft. Note on deck 1 and deck 2 is still get to deck 4 to meet Dr. Polito. So, I'm gonna make a new quick save, I'm gonna make a new main save, hydroponics B and C, and I'm gonna call it a video. Thank you all for watching. This has been Let's Play System Shock 2. We turned the main power back online and got the elevator working, but there's a shaft blockage above deck 3, so we'll handle that next time. I'll see you then. Bye-bye.